What do you think the value of a computer is from all the training you've had?
I really like them. They help so much with everything. They go, you know, into education, and you know, you can go on continuing with them into, you know, pictures and television and all sorts of things like that.
How has it helped you in school?
It's really taught me the value of learning the formulas that they, you know, they say you have to learn this formula, and you go, why? You know, why can't you do it the easy way? And then, you know, you see that the formula is really the easy way.
And then you work it out on the computer.
Yeah.
And what class is it most helpful with, would you say?
Well, with math and science and also, you know, everything. I've been able to put it into all my classes.
Makes it a lot easier?
Yeah.
What do you plan to go into?
Computer science.
Okay, all right, very good. Problem, leave it alone. Okay, we've got Kevin O'Neill here, and Kevin is working on a computer. Kevin, what are you doing here?
Well, we're programming this computer how to, like, find the product with two numbers, and it, like, tells you what numbers to put in, and then it'll find the product for you.
Does this make schooling real easy?
Yeah, it helps, like, if you want to make a harder, you know, like of big numbers if you needed to multiply or something. But other than, you know, for this kind of program, other than that, that's about all it'll help you for.
How has it helped you in school? I mean, you've been only in here, what, 3 days, though, haven't you?
Yeah, right, in the computer room, right.
Yeah, so it's hard for you to explain it, but how do you see the computer as helping you in school?
I could see that it could help you in a lot of ways, like to figure out, you know, if you find out harder programs. For some of these programs here, like for to help you find factoring for polynomials and things like that, like up there, helping a lot of ways for like advanced algebra.
It does some of the thinking for you, doesn't it?
Yeah, right. And you know, but you got to do a lot of thinking too to think up the program, right? So it helps you even more that way too.
What are you going to do with the computer when you leave this course?
I don't know. I might. Just play games on it and to help me with my homework, you know, if I need it.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Kevin.
Sure.
Sure. Okay. This is a real nice program to have here. And let's run it again and try it with these numbers. See, we tried it with one.
Next number is 4.1.
There you go. And there you go. Okay. We have to do that one by hand. Look at number 10C. What should the answer to that turn out to be if we get the product of those?
Zero.
All right, let's give it a shot.
Okay. Space, et le choix multiple.
Choix multiple.
Écrivez votre prénom. Ah, pas accepté parce que tu dois faire. Tu as choisi. Très bien. Continuez. Allez. Je ne sais pas si tu dois rester ici. Alors, il est probable. Là, vous n'avez pas. Est-ce que vous avez le subjonctif? Très bien, mademoiselle. Vous avez là une proposition. Essayez. Lequel? A, B, C, O, D.
A, S.
A, S, okay. All right, now you're, what year are you?
Junior.
You're a junior, okay. All right, Athena, how does this computer help you to learn French?
It writes, you can see it in that, and then it helps you pick out the right, like, subject or the right verb to put in. If you see it written out in front of you, you can tell better what's right instead of hearing it only.
Is it better than just the teacher trying to teach French?
Well, it helps also the teacher. You know, the teacher teaches you some, but it helps also too.
Do you find it's a game, sort of, that you're playing on it?
A little bit. It's a lot funner than just sitting in class all day. But it helps along with the class. So.
Very good. Thank you. All right, as we're rolling. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Glenbrook South High School has one of the most advanced computer programs in the country. The school has two labs. One is called the Apple Orchard, where each computer has a different name, such as Red Delicious, Macintosh, and so on. All right.
There's no disc. There's nothing on the screen.
It's all right, we don't mind.
Get the ship changed.
Then I wrote my program. I think Robin Redford is gorgeous. That's gorgeous.
It was there.
Okay, I'm going to teach you. Very nice. So everything you need to do the project.
Well, yes.
Oh, I didn't say do the programming for.
Right.
Are there enough examples so that you can see what's going to happen with your data?
Usually.
How do you pull up the data set from Mr. Wagner's?
Babe, something's happening with my thing.
Okay, so you know what to do.
I got it.
Yeah,
I didn't have all this in there before.
Well, the
EA
file, yeah.
Why don't you sign
off?
So every time I add, I get
a new file. All you gotta do is get rid of /i.
Oops.
That's i. And now it'll work with all the programs.
And do what?
So not much for listing. Should. Now, if you press a K, it kills that file for me. That's return to keep to.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it just goes through all the files and the K's.
Oh, wow.
Most of your apps.
Not real long. Is it Dr. McConnell?
Yes.
All right. And you're what? Your title would be?
Well, I'm instructional supervisor of mathematics and director of instructional computing within the high school, and I also make sure there's toilet paper in the girls' john.
Pulling Barry. Little setup shot that we're getting here as we're. All right, Dr. John McConnell, McConnell.
Yes.
Correct spelling. All right. Dr. McConnell, what basically is the goal of the computer program that you have offered here at Glenbrook South?
There are three areas of computing that we're concerned with in our district. The two major areas that we're working on right now are computer-assisted instruction and computer programming. The computer programming is split into two separate areas. The formal computer programming courses we offer in mathematics and business education, and the computer literacy program, which we're aiming at all students with an eye to producing students who by the sophomore year have some rudimentary knowledge of the basic language, which is one of the most common languages for contemporary microcomputers.
In other words, when a student leaves this school, he or she should have been able to use a computer at some time.
Yes, and not just use the computer, but actually do some programming on a computer. We think that computing is an intellectual skill, that it goes beyond just being able to operate a computer and get special symbols on the screen. But it provides students with more personal feeling of power, it represents new areas for inquiry in itself, and it will assist students to attack some major problems. In mathematics, we have a lot of problems which we can handle better with the graphics facilities that we now have on microcomputers than we could by hand many years ago. I can't teach trigonometry without a computer handy now. I need to show those graphs very rapidly and very easily. So I think we're going to gain a new perspective on many areas of our subject matter. One of the biggest users in our school has been our music department. Had one told us 5 years ago that the music department would be a major user of computers in, today, in 1982, we'd have laughed them out of the room. But the fact remains the modern microcomputer and modern computers in general are very, very powerful machines. They will affect our lives in significant and unexpected ways. We want our students to be less surprised than we are.
What makes your program here, the curriculum, successful in your judgment?
Very exciting student body. I think our students have jumped into computers with no fear. They have been accepted computers very eagerly. They've been willing to put in the hard work. One of the features of this particular room is a computer which has permitted us to double the student requirements in many of our programming courses. And in this day and age, when you talk about doubling requirements, which are received eagerly by kids, you're talking about a very surprising phenomenon. The second area has been staff. Our Board of Education funded extensive staff training on microcomputers and in computers in general. The staff have been very ingenious. They have located commercially available software, which is good stuff, which can build into our existing curriculum, or they have designed their own. We have several teachers who were not programmers at all 18 months ago who are very excellent programmers now in producing top-notch software. Again, who would have expected that a French teacher would produce an excellent French program for advanced placement French 18 months ago? But we have that happen.
As an educator, how do you see the role of the computer in the classroom, the teacher versus the computer? Will the computer replace the classroom teacher? How do you see it?
In the short term, the computer is a definite aid to help us teach our subject areas better. In mathematics, there are certain things we can do with the computer that we can't do with a calculator, that we could never do with a slide rule, that we couldn't do with graph board, chalkboard, and whatever facilities we have had. So there are many areas where the computer is working in right now to be a very effective classroom aid. The second area is going to come about because of the lack of qualified math and science teachers. Even though the newspapers and TV broadcasters may be full of news about teacher surpluses, even though we have teacher cutbacks here on the North Shore, the long-term view for math and science is a very severe shortage of teachers. We will need good software, combined not just computers, but computer and video disc probably, which will provide the math and science education that won't be provided by teachers, small rural schools, first of all. The Minnesota Educational Computer Consortium has taken a first step in this area. They have developed an economics course which is based on video disc and computer for dissemination to primarily rural Minnesota schools who cannot support an economics class because they don't have an economics teacher. So we may see a crisis in math and science teacher supplies, which are going to provide the impetus for publishers to put in a teaching package of algebra or a teaching package of geometry. So the future, it will not come because the computer is necessarily better than a teacher, but because there won't be that many teachers around. Math and science teachers will be being hired by businesses to run computers. So the economic forces are pulling teachers away from education.
All right, very good.
So it's a superb community to live in, and I love what I'm seeing with my children in the field of computers. My third grader gets some formal computer education. And the question is, what are we going to have to be in 6 years when she's a freshman?
He has a beep every time it's your turn, so if another person takes a while, you'll know when it comes back to you. And also, if you wait a while, you'll see.
Wait a while.
Yeah, if I decide, you know, I'm not going to answer for a while and try to hold up the game.
You two just play and don't talk to Larry. You would, please.